Explain us the meaning of this shlokam.
Well, it's really a beautiful meaning. The slokas are from an ancient text, the shastras. It's really beautiful once you understand. The meaning is the body should catch up with the tune. And the hastas, the gesture, should speak the meaning, and the eyes should express the emotion, and the feet should beat the rhythm. And the second sloka meaning is, it's about the Angika Abhinaya. In Angika Abhinaya, there's no particular meaning, there's no sentiment attached to it. It's just a beauty of rhythm.
Is it common in all classical forms?
Oh yeah, this fourfold Abhinaya, what I'm going to speak to you today, is common for all the dance forms. It's not restricted only to Bharatanatyam or Kuchipudi or Kathakali or Mohiniyattam or Odissi and the other dance forms. It's common to all. It's called the fourfold Abhinaya. Now the first Abhinaya is called the Angika. Anga means the limbs. And it's beautifully defined in the text, like how these limbs are divided. So we have Anga, Upanga and the Pratyanga. So I just want you to see the board. I'll be showing it to you and see how these classifications are done. Now, what did you observe? Angika, it is not just the face or the eyes. The whole body should express. Like in dance, the nritta becomes the part of Angika Abhinaya. Nritta means what? Devoid of any sentiments. It's the movements. Like I taught you a lot of these basic steps, they all come under the category of nritta. So now I'll just show you how the combination of the steps are done. It's also part of the angika abhinaya. Now what I'm going to show, like some of the steps which I taught you, so I'm just going to use the same steps. You will see how when the singer starts that, so how the combination is done for the swaras. Okay, swaras means, you understand what is swaras? The notes. No, sari gama, that is the sari gama. Yeah. After four count we will start. 1, 2, 3, start. Well, the whole beauty of the Angika Abhinaya is, it's just not the nritta what I showed you, that is the steps, but also when we are expressing, like I'm just going to show you, you tell me what I'm asking.
And who are you?
No.
It's pointing you.
You. Okay, then.
Why didn't you come?
Yeah, why you not come? So from this, what do you understand?
Why didn't you come yesterday?
No, what do you understand with these gestures?
It's a silent conversation.
Yes, it's a silent conversation. Because when suppose we sing that we don't have any music. Okay, so I'm just doing. So what do you understand? That even every tip of the fingers has life in Angika Abhinaya. We cannot be very dull. Then there shouldn't be any impact. You have to bring life even to your finger movements. Like for example, this is the lotus bud. Try. Yeah. Because even the fingers and the wrists, everything parts of the Angika Abhinaya. Okay, this is the bud. Now it is blooming into a beautiful flower. But what happens? I just do that. There's no life. Can you feel it?
No, ma'am.
No. But what will happen? So what happens? We are slightly moving our fingers. So that gives life to the blooming of the flower. So it's not dead. So it's not that bhava or the expression. That's why it's called Angika Abhinaya. Even every part of our limbs will express. Like for example, all of you get up, I'll show you. We take a village scene. Village, what is common? People go to take water from the well. Okay?
Yes,
say we walk, then I show a big well. So just watch. I show the big well. Then I'm tying. I'm just waiting for the water to get filled up. I'm holding. Then I have to pull. You need strength to pull the heavy bucket. You got it?
Yes.
How? Like even the simple gesture like mushti is used. The wrist is moving. So that's also part of the Angika Abhinaya. Like we are not just doing the straight or doing this. Like bending of the spine because I'm going to look down. So that's also the Angika Abhinaya. Now can you just think of some example to show using the Angika Abhinaya?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
We can show as if like the birds in the sky, they're like flying and all of us are like watching.
Okay, try.
Yeah, just try. The movement of the, for the birds, the toe. You understood? Now it's not only the nritta, the step is Angika Abhinaya, but all these limbs, because that also expresses in dance.
And can we also show like as if we are sitting in an examination hall and we are trying to write? And then, like, we try to remember something.
Yeah, you try. Let me sit and watch.
Can you try?
What imagination you come?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, try. But Garima, only one thing, you have to remember the coordination. You have to think what you are depicting. You are depicting writing.
Yes.
And you showed a paper of this size. So you won't go away from the paper to write. Okay, so you are just trying. So you are actually doing all over your writing. Okay, so the thought process, you'll have to remember, well, this is the paper. So I'm writing within this limitation. Yeah, in dance throughout, you have to focus what exactly you are doing. So how we have to do? You cannot just do, though it is Angika Abhinaya, yeah, it's a mundane thing, you are studying in school. But still logically, you cannot write outside the paper. Okay, so anyhow it was correct, but next time you can take care of it, whatever you are trying to depict.
Ma'am, I must say, all these expressions make your performance so lively.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, you saw that now without your knowledge, what's happening? You're writing, then you're thinking.
Mm-hmm.
The normal circumstances when somebody is thinking, naturally the eyes will go up. So the eyes, the netra, that also becomes part of the Angika Abhinaya. They're trying to think. They're not trying to write. So you understood how simple it is.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now the next division of expression is Vachika. Vachika means the dialogue. The dialogue in drama in ancient time, because the Natya was a combination of music, dance and drama. In Natya, even the actor had to sing as well as speak the dialogue as well as the dance. That's why the term Natya. But nowadays, especially in classical dance form, we don't sing. The dancer, we don't sing. But our Vachika Abhinaya is the singer. Like, I do not speak the lyrics, but the singer is going to speak the lyrics through a music. So that is the Vachika. In drama, Vachika means the verbal communication. Verbally you talk, it's very simple. Why did you come so late? What is the reason that you came late so? It's verbal, so communication is easy. But in dance, the singer is singing. That's why we have to use the Angika Abhinaya and also the Bhava, the expressions. Because otherwise you won't understand, because she's singing the word, the meaning.
Yes.
If I'm speaking verbal communication, you understand, because It's easy. So one has to practice this expression. The beauty of the Indian classical dance itself is the facial expression, including the whole body which speaks. Okay? Now just see now how the singer is going to speak the Vachika Abhinaya through a singing.
Solla vallayo.
I think I'll dance for this.
Kiliye solla ni vallayo. Kiliye solla vallayo. Kiliye solla ni vallayo. Kiliye.
Yeah, I'll tell you the meaning. It's a Tamil song written by one of the well-known patriotic poet, Subramanya Bharati, from Tamil Nadu. Now, he has written large quantum of songs. Now, in this song, the beauty is, in olden time, you know that whether you had a postman. I'm talking very ancient days. You had a postman? No.
No.
You didn't have the...
People used to...
Yeah. Yes, ma'am. So in this song I'm saying, oh, the beautiful parrot, have you come to pass on my message? Okay. Then I pet the parrot, I show the tree, I pluck a small fruit. Before making it fly with my message, I'm feeding the parrot. So then I write my letter, I fold the letter and tie it, then I send the parrot. So I'm watching the sky, it's flying path. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So this is how verbal, that is Vachika Abhinaya. Of course, in some style of dance, like in Kuchipudi, in one or two items, they do speak. Like there's a very famous item called the Bhama Kalapam, where the dancer herself will speak the dialogue. Then in ancient time, some of the temple dancers were also singing and dancing. But they didn't have the musicians in the temple. Sometimes they were singing and also dancing. Now this Vachika Abhinaya, but in recent times, like even in dance production, when we are presenting something, if you want to make more impact with what we are saying, we might have the commentary. So we might dance for the commentary before we start to perform. So that you can take it as an example of verbal communication.